Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Jake from todaysiphone.com, and here's some big news this week. Now, obviously, the biggest news this week is the release of the white iPhone 4. It is on sale now for both AT&T and Verizon, and, I mean, it's white. So if you're one of the people who was waiting 10 months to get their hands on a white iPhone 4, you can finally go out and buy one. We have a ton of coverage on this device, including an unboxing video and a hands-on video. And I gotta say that even though I wasn't very excited about the white iPhone 4, it definitely looks really nice. But I mean, it's purely an aesthetic update. There's absolutely no difference other than the color between that and the black iPhone 4. So it's really just a preference of what you want your phone to look like. However, a couple interesting things to note about the white iPhone 4 is that, for one, Cam did a video testing whether the white iPhone 4 suffered from the death grip issue like the black iPhone 4 does, and while he did see some signal loss when covering up the little black strip on the bottom left corner of the phone, the signal did not drop out completely like it sometimes does on the black iPhone 4. Now, this could be due to an internal antenna fix by Apple, or it really could just come down to how strong your signal is at the time. But honestly, at this point, everything regarding the whole antenna issue has pretty much died away. I mean, use a case if you want to, don't use a case, it's really not that bad either way. Another thing to keep in mind about the white iPhone 4 is that apparently it is like tiny, tiny bit thicker than the black iPhone 4. And while it hasn't really caused that much of a problem, there have been reports of cases that fit perfectly for the black iPhone 4 being almost too tight on the white iPhone 4 and even not fitting. So definitely watch out for that. There is a possibility that some of your accessories for your black iPhone 4 may not be as compatible with the white iPhone 4. If you guys are experiencing any issues with your white iPhone 4 and some accessories that you carried over from your black version, definitely let me know about it in the comment section down below. Okay. That's it. We can stop talking about the white iPhone 4. And you know, with WWDC and summer just around the corner, I'd say that's pretty much the end of the iPhone 4 rumors in general. We are pretty much moving on to the iPhone 5 rumors right now as the launch of that device gets closer and closer. So in the spirit of that, Cam put out a list of the most likely iPhone 5 rumors out there right now. Now, he talks about everything from iOS 5 and the iCloud service that Apple is rumored to announce, to the A5 processor inside the device, to a T-Mobile version of the iPhone, and even a 3.7-inch Retina display as opposed to a 3.5. Now, judging by the evidence for each one of these rumors and like Apple's past history with device updates and stuff, I'd say this is a pretty accurate list as to what we're gonna see on the next iteration of the iPhone. I'm especially excited for the 3.7-inch Retina display. MIC Gadgets released a picture of what they claim is an iPhone 5 rocking a 3.7-inch screen, and I gotta say, it looks really nice. Alright, moving right along, in applications news, I want to tell you guys about this really fun game called Tiny Wings. Our own Jennifer Dickert is very happy with this game, saying it combines the fun physics aspect of Angry Birds with the bouncy progression of Doodle Jump. It's colorful and entertaining, and it's one of those quick, casual games that you can play waiting in a bus stop or waiting between classes, and then you can just put your phone in your pocket and pick it up later. Now, the artwork and scenery for this game is really nice. To me, it looks like a Dr. Seuss book, kind of, but keep in mind that it is not optimized for the Retina display, which is kind of confusing. I mean, at this point, with the iPhone 4 being out for so long, I'd assume that all the game makers out there would be going for the Retina display, just because it looks so much better, but hopefully that comes in an application update. Now, there have been some issues with lag with this application, but overall, the app earned 4 stars on today's iPhone, and it's definitely recommended for anybody who likes the type of game like Angry Birds or Doodle Jump. Now, if this sounds appealing to you, you can check out Jennifer's full review on todaysiphone.com, or pick up the application from the App Store for 99 cents. Alright, next, as you guys know, we are always trying to improve our videos and our posts on the site to fit what you guys are looking for, and in the spirit of that, Cam has begun doing a question and answer video where he basically answers your questions about the site, about iPhones, or about him personally, as well as taking suggestions for what you guys want to see from us. Now, this is a really cool way to interact with the TIP readers aside from the traditional Twitter or YouTube comments. So if you have any questions or suggestions or comments for Cam, definitely head over to todaysiphone.com or youtube.com/todaysiphone and check out his question and answer video. And finally, in jailbreak news, People really like the GarageBand application that Apple has released for the iPad 2, with the instruments that you can play right on the device and the ability to hook it up to real live instruments and record your own music right to your iPad. However, the one thing that people weren't too happy about was that it was iPad only. So one iOS user took this into his own hands and hacked the application and his phone, and he was able to get the iPad version of GarageBand to run on his jailbroken iPhone 4. Now definitely check out the post on today's iPhone with a video of this in action, but keep in mind that as of now, this is only possible if you jailbreak your device, which could void your warranty. Well, that's it for this week, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and remember, the links to all of these stories I talked about in this video are in the description below, and for more news, views, and reviews, definitely head over to todaysiphone.com. And if you want to connect with me a little bit more, you talk about iOS, iPhone, or just random questions, definitely follow me on Twitter at TIPJake. I love talking to you guys and answering questions. And in the spirit of shameless self-promotion, I want to tell you guys about this film I made for this film festival that really has nothing to do with iPhones, so you can turn this video off now if you want. A couple of my friends and I did a video for Campus Movie Fest, which is the largest student film festival in the world. They go to a bunch of colleges across the country and even some other countries. I just wanted to give you guys a little info about it because I've been tweeting about it a lot and I've had some questions about it. My group actually ended up winning Best Picture for my college, which is so awesome. And if you're interested, I'd love to know what you think about it. I will put a link to the video in the description down below. We worked really hard on it, so I hope you guys like it. Okay, that's it. I'm done. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next week.